Kentaro Miura did not exist, then Inio Asano would likely be the greatest mangaka to ever live. His obsession with detail and realism gives his works a sense of immersion that few even dare to replicate. Out of his impressive list of notable works, I would like to talk about a short, two-volume little story he created throughout 2005 and 2006 named Solanine. I love his longer series too, of course, especially the infamously morbid and psychological masterpiece Oyasami Punpun, but Solanine will always have a place in my hobo heart for how much of an impact something so short could leave on me. In case you haven't read it yet, allow me to sell you on its appeal before strongly encouraging you to go and read it for yourself. Solanine is a grounded story about two young Tokyo adults trying to live together as happily as possible. Despite their best efforts, satisfaction in life seems to be an ever-fleeting ideal, as Meiko struggles in her search for a popular career, and Taneda wishes he could become successful with his band he started with his friends back in college. Every character in the manga is shockingly realistic, as if they really were people Asano knew at some point in his life. The circumstances they find themselves in, the dialogue amongst each other, and the pain they all must learn to grow from create an unforgettable dose of realistic slice-of-life medicine that would likely make anyone relate to their stories in some way. There is one problem with this manga, however. This is a tale heavily revolving around music, and while I do think that Asano does a fantastic job in his attempt to cover this blemish, the lack of actual sound can leave many of the performance scenes feeling a tad barren. If only there were a... oh. Perfect. In 2010, Solanine was adapted into a feature-length film by director Takehiro Miki. It's time I spill the beans on this whole video. This is my favorite movie of all time. Sure, I love the manga, but the film adaptation is far and away the best way to experience the narrative. Inio Asano is known for his immaculate detail in his backgrounds, and panels that feel so real one could reach through the page and feel the breeze in the air. The potential in his work for proper film conversions makes all too much sense, as live-action movies are particularly great at conveying realism. There are so many 10 out of 10 shots in Solanine. Sure, they are, for the most part, based on the book, but they're done so well in this film that I think they actually work better in this medium. On a technical level, the cinematography, directing, acting, and writing are all very stylized, and perhaps won't go down in history as quote-unquote good, whatever that means. In my opinion, the shots are perfect. The scene's lengths can be a little long, but it's deliberate and it's captivating in that way. The acting is perhaps a touch over the top, but so are real people, and it takes a truly excellent actor to play an instrument and play a character at the same time. The writing, despite mostly being lifted from the book, works so much better in motion that it's hard to believe at times. And then there are the themes. What it means to be an adult, how to handle living together, whether or not to give up on your dreams, and most importantly, how to move on from your past self. Taken all together, the underlying elements of Solanine create a movie experience unlike anything else I've witnessed. The only issue is the inability to actually watch the damn thing. Torrents of the film can be found, but subtitles are hit or miss, and legal means like Amazon don't offer very friendly results. But even if it is inconvenient to find, I strongly encourage all of you out there to give it a shot. The movie is slow sometimes, but stay with it and you'll feel a payoff unlike anything else you've likely watched.
どこにいるの？今何してんの？
そんな一度に聞かないでよ。俺
りあえず新しく携帯買い替えたところ。
俺は音楽でね、世界を変えようと本気で思ってた。でもこの頃はミュージシャンになりたいんじゃなくてバンドがやりたかっただけなんじゃんってさ。
みんながいてメイコがいて、本当はそれだけでいいんだ。
もう別れるなんて言わないよね。
言わないよ。
あ、メイコさん、それから最後にもう一言、愛してる。
ずいぶん思い切ったこと言ったね。
そうですよ、ずいぶん強がったこと言っちゃったよ。俺は一つだけ言えてないことがある。
何？
僕は君のことが好きなんだ。
うん、知ってた。
帰ったらラブソングでも作ってみよっかな。
じゃあ早く帰ろ。寒い